My name is Sara Cates. I am in Kansas City, Missouri, and I am a pulmonary hypertension patient. So I actually heard about PH for the first time in an emergency room visit. I had symptoms ongoing for over a year that included a racing heart, a battle with pneumonia that I just couldn't overcome, and it got to the point where like I would have blue lips and coughing fits and real bad dizzy spells. And I was going to a public hospital at the time, and they were running all kinds of tests to kind of see what was going on with me. And it wasn't until I went into an emergency room visit that one of the doctors told me that I had pulmonary hypertension. So my first reaction was to go to Google, and which was a really bad idea. Google scared me completely. But through that, they got me into a pulmonologist there at the public hospital, and the pulmonary doctor kind of went over what pulmonary hypertension was and how my body was fighting. They put me on oxygen that day. But at that point, they told me that since it was such a rare disease, that they actually were not capable of treating me and that I would have to find a specialist that deals with rare diseases. It was actually about 6 months before insurance went through and all of that, but I did get in to see a specialist. So my son, he was 6 years old at the time I was diagnosed, which was 5 years ago. So he's 11 now. At the time of diagnosis, single mom, I was going to school, I was working management in a restaurant and just doing everything that I could, that I knew how to survive. And then I just got real sick one day, and over the course of the year and a half, it got really bad. After diagnosis and reading the statistics about pulmonary hypertension, it really just got me in a deep depressive state. I was pretty much convinced that my days were numbered, and I was really depressed because as a single mom, I wasn't entirely sure what was going to happen to my son. So I found a lot of comfort in eating. Without treatment, I was just on 24/7 oxygen, and I was at home. I had to quit working, and my weight got up to nearly 300 pounds just through depression and defeat. I got diagnosed in October, and the weight gain happened over about a 5 or 6 month period. I didn't get in to see my pulmonary specialist until May of that following year. So by the time that I reached my specialist, I was a mess. My heart was failing. I was on 24/7 oxygen, and I was just really defeated. My weight had gotten out of control. So I sat down with that doctor, and, you know, he closed the door, and he said, all right, we don't have time limits. Tell me your story. Tell me what it took to get you here. And I just poured out my heart to him, and he gave me a hug, and he was like, okay, we're going to tackle this thing. He says, I'm going to do my part. We're going to put you on dual therapy. And he's like, I can't promise that you'll ever be off oxygen or that things are going to get better. He's like, but we're really going to tackle this. And he said that you still have to do your part. And I just kind of looked at him, and he said, your part is that you have to lose weight. The problem is that my heart was failing and I wasn't allowed to exercise to lose the weight. I was in college at the time I was diagnosed. I actually had to switch to online classes, but I was in the Honor Society. And by God's grace, one of the gentlemen in my Honor Society reached out to me, and he was like, hey, I want to meet up. I've got some information for you that I think could be really beneficial. I hadn't shared a whole lot of my story on social media, but just enough to where people knew I was struggling. So I met with him at the library, and he actually shared with me a whole lot of information. He shared with me about a whole food plant-based diet, about juicing raw fruits and vegetables, and gave me a book about juicing. And he shared with me some documentaries that had not only helped his life, but a lot of other people that were struggling with medical illnesses. He shared with me the documentary Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead, which is about an Australian gentleman that went on a juice fast for 40 days here in America and cured a skin disorder and lost a whole bunch of weight. And while I never thought that I would cure pulmonary hypertension, I did know that I needed to lose weight and that I had been given this thorn. Now, what do I do with it? I wanted to make the best of what I was dealing with, and I certainly didn't want to add any more diseases on top of what I was already facing. So I started juicing in May of that year, the same time that I started seeing my specialist. It all happened within the same month, which was really cool. I got a juicer for graduation, and I just started juicing as much as I could, playing with recipes and doing all of that. And I decided that I did want to go on a juice cleanse. So I think my first one was about 10 days. Which was really hard and was unlike anything I'd ever done before. I didn't even eat vegetables prior to this. I was completely standard American diet. But the documentary had sparked so much hope in my heart that I was like, I don't have anything to lose. So I did. I started juicing. My first one was for 10 days. And then I noticed that my heart was kind of like, I wasn't feeling too hot with that. So I was like, okay, you know, I'm going to just juice as much as possible and eat whole food plant-based meals. And I do want to say that it's technically a vegan diet, but it's different from a vegan diet. Vegan diets still contain processed foods and it's more of an ethical choice, but whole food plant-based eating is basically taking whole ingredients and making meals. I just started doing that in May of that year. By October, I had lost a significant amount of weight. I went back to my pulmonary specialist and he was so amazed at my results. And we tested my oxygen and actually got to go off oxygen that day. And then within a year of doing this switch of being on juice and whole food plant-based diet, I had lost 100 pounds. I had cured sleep apnea and my heart had actually returned to normal size and function. My doctor has been there every step of this. I do monthly lab work, even still to this day, 5 years later, I'm still doing monthly lab work. I see my specialist every 3 months so that if anything were to go awry, we would know really quickly. But yeah, my doctor has been here through the entire process and really just been my biggest cheerleader in all of this. As soon as I watched the first documentary about juicing and this guy transforming his life, it sparked a little bit of hope in me. And I just remember like it was like this fire that lit up and the depression almost instantly lifted. And as I started fueling my body more with plant foods and then I saw all of this process of everything changing, I switched from being depressed to just being filled with hope. And then at one point it just switched over from hope to like kind of motivation because I saw like the amazing things that were happening with me. And I was like, wow, more people need to know about this. So then it became like this passion and this drive for me that even to this day, like I can't not share the message because it's changed my life so radically. When I was diagnosed, I was put on permanent disability. And we all know that disability, you do not get a lot of money to live on. And the amount of fruits and vegetables that I was eating was exponential. I was eating more than I could possibly buy on my paycheck. So I started growing food in my backyard. In the beginning, it was really hard because, you know, as a pulmonary hypertension patient, we have good days, we have bad days, and there are days where, you know, you just can't do anything. So I would go out in the mornings when I had the most energy and I would just start cultivating my backyard. I started planting as much food, you know, as much plants and seeds as I possibly could to kind of offset the cost. And then I kind of became an avid gardener through this and I found ways to set myself up to where in the heat of the summer that I wouldn't have to go out and tend the garden so much. I could just go harvest what I needed. So that's been a really huge asset to me that I have access to fresh fruits and vegetables. During diagnosis, I was finishing up my first degree. It was a degree in psychology. But then when I saw like the power that was in this whole food plant-based diet and I started like really just digging into my own research, it prompted me to go back to school. And I went back to school focusing on a degree in biology because I just wanted to know as much as I could about this. And I am happy to say that I just graduated last month with a degree in biology and chemistry. And I'm excited to see where my education takes me with that. Oh, and I'm just excited to see where this road leads from here. My name is Sara Cates, and I'm aware that I'm rare.